Hello, hello, and welcome. Welcome, Sterling C. Sample here. Coming to you with another class, okay, guys? This one will be about the circle of fourths and fifths. Now, you know we have the pan called the fourths and fifth pan, and we have the thirds and fourth pans. The fourths and fifth pans is made up of a sequence of notes separated by fifths, okay? They're all separated by fifths. And when you play them in a sequence, they tend to go how music goes. And if they was to go anti-clockwise, they go clockwise, it ends up as a, like the form of a clock. Let me show you this little instrument I have in front of me here. It's just like make up of the fourth and fifth. It's make up like our fourth and fifth, but our fourth and fifth goes like from here. You have your C down here, and your F and your B. But how is if when you file it online, you will see it like this. It's like a clock. See, I got 12 o'clock here. Let me show you on the screen here. See, like I got 12 o'clock there. See, like this is the clock finish. That's the clock finish right there. Okay, 12, 11, 10 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 8 o'clock, 1 o'clock. We could bring it back down here. So 12 o'clock is C, G is 1 o'clock, D is 2 o'clock, A is 3 o'clock, A, B, C, D, E is 4 o'clock, E, F, G, A, B is 5 o'clock, B, A, C, D, F sharp, 6 o'clock, F sharp, G, A, B, D, D flat. When you come on this side, it's come flat. So this side you have the sharps. On one side you have the flats, okay? So when we come back, we're gonna go into this class. Okay, see you in a minute. All right, we are back, and this class is gonna be done with the world famous electronic steel pan. Okay, the steel pan can give you all different songs. So I'm gonna just keep the steel pan song for you guys, and maybe in between I might give you a little, one or two little notes about the different song, this lovely instrument I have here, right? So the circle of fifths, we're gonna start from C, okay, guys, and we're gonna go five notes up from C. You use the C major scale. Use the C major scale, okay? C major scale. This thing dealing with scales. It's not dealing with the it's not dealing like in a chromatic way. It goes with scales, okay? And the scales, you check the scale, you go in the fifth and the fourth, okay? So C major, as we learned in the class before, is C D C D E F G A B C C D E F G C C D E F G A B C. Right, so you check five notes from the C, okay? Five notes from the C major scale. The fifth note on the C major scale will be your next note, your next scale, your next chord, okay? So five notes from the C major scale will be C is 1, D is 2, E is 3, F is 4, G is 5. Okay, your fifth note, okay? So you take that fifth note, excuse me, I don't know why I snore. So you take that fifth note and you make your next, you take your next scale, okay? So this is C is at 12 o'clock. That's at 12 o'clock. Now you go to 1 o'clock, which is G. And 1 o'clock have a significance behind it, okay, guys? 1 o'clock have a significance behind 1 o'clock. It's just 1 o'clock, just like that. Watch and I will show you. Okay? Watch and you will learn why it's called 1 o'clock. This is C at 12 o'clock. This is like the starting of your day, you know, midnight. Right? Your fifth note could be G. You take your G major scale, the same scale you just learned just now, your D major, G major scale. Right? G major scale, right? And what's the difference significant between these two scales is that C major and G major only have one note apart. At 1 o'clock, it have one note apart. At 1 o'clock, it have one note apart. Check it out. C, D, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. Right? C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. Now, there's many ways to get that too. You can say, well, next chord, your next note, you go five notes up, and you sharpen your fourth note, or you flatten your fourth note, you know? You sharpen your fourth note, right? Your fourth note is F in the C major scale. One, two, three, four, that F can be sharp but the next when you're coming back around. But you're playing the same C major scale, but you're starting from G. But you're playing, the different notes could be F sharp. You play the same C major scale from G, but one note gonna change, the note gonna change, it's gonna be F sharp. So play C major scale again, C major. I play a C major scale from G now, go five notes up, your fifth note, five notes up from C, right? C again, C, D, E, F, G is your fifth note. Now start from G and play the same C major scale. Right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You see the fifth? One, two, three, four. The D is the fifth, right? On the G. Sharpen the seventh. Either sharpen the seventh, or you say your next time you come around, you sharpen your fourth. But you're sharpening the seventh. The F fall on the seventh. Okay, the F fall on the 7th degree. So on the 7th degree, you sharpen it. Let's don't get too deep. The F fall on the 7th degree. Okay, let me play with the F. Right? You have something with the F? Yeah? That's with the F. Here it with the F sharp now. More is resolved, more resolved here. In music they call that resolving. So you sharpen the seventh. Sharpen the seventh, right? So you get that your first sharp at 1 o'clock. So let's recap. C. No sharps, no flat. C major scale, no sharps, no flat. Right? Then they go G major scale. One sharp. Which is F sharp. Alright? And they go a fifth up from that now. G, G, A, B, C. So D is the next chord. D is the next scale you're going on. Right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So let's take the D major scale now. We learned just now the D major scale. Right? So this D major scale, it have to have the F sharp in it and then one more sharp, okay? It have an F sharp in it and then unless you sharpen your seventh. Now, as they go forward, all the sharps that you learn is gonna come into the next key. The next key you're playing in, the next chord you're playing in. So only one note difference from onto the next key. From C in C and G is only one note difference between C and G major. In G and D major is only one note different from G and D major. And it goes forward as it go on, it's gonna be happy. It's just one note different. That's why that's why those notes are so familiar with each other. You can solo in those keys and it could sound very nice, you know. That's how they make music, okay? So D, right? That's C, right? G, F sharp, one sharp in G. Now D is your fifth note. from the G. You're going around the circle, right? You're at 2 o'clock now. Right? F sharp. Remember F sharp, right? This is where F sharp fall. F sharp fall on the third. 1, 2, 3. Right? The F sharp fall on the third. You see F sharp there? The F sharp fall on the third note in G. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4. The B, right? C sharp, 77. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. B is the 6. C sharp. You're supposed to play C, right? Now, go back again. Okay, let me don't get you confused. Go back again and play the G major scale. Okay, then play the same G major scale, but started from F. Okay, take the same G major scale and start it from D, right? Started from the fourth note, which is D. So play the same G major scale, right? Play the same G major scale, but started from D, and add and sharpen your seventh. C sharp. So let's see C sharp, okay? So your next sharp, you end up with two sharps at 2 o'clock. So at 2 o'clock, where you find D, have two sharps at 2 o'clock. Okay, guys, two sharps at 2 o'clock. That's it. D, two sharps at 2 o'clock. Now let's go to 3 o'clock now. How you find 3 o'clock? Do the same thing with the D. Go D. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? After G, the D, and then the next one go be, the next one go be A, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You go 5 notes up. Right? You go 5 notes up. That's why they call it fourth and fifth. You go 5 notes up. When you're going this way around the clock, you start at 12 o'clock in the night. It's 1 o'clock in the morning. Then it's 2 o'clock in the morning. Right now we are 3 o'clock in the morning. 3 o'clock in the morning, we have 3 o'clock in the 2 o'clock in the morning, we have D. And 3 o'clock in the morning, we have A. Right? Right? Same notes. Remember the same notes you're playing, okay? You ain't deviating from the same notes. You're playing the same notes, but you're just changing. It's seventh, okay? So it's seventh. So it's A. Remember that B? Remember that C sharp? Remember that C? That F? F sharp? Right? A. Right? And the E? Right? All those notes was in the D just now, right? Remember your C sharp on the F? C sharp on the F sharp? And your D? And your F sharp? Right? Right? And your last note is gonna be G, right? But you're sharpening that G. You're sharpening the G7, which is G. Sharp, remember F sharp? F sharp, after F is what? G, right? So you're sharpening that G. Excuse the sniffing. I don't know where this cold sniffing come out from, but absolutely sniffing, but we're gonna get through this class, okay guys? Let's take it again. Let's take it again. I'm on a roll here, so I cannot stop us. I can't stop, I'm on a roll, okay guys? G sharp, back to A. So one note different between C and G, one note different between G and D, one note different between D and A. Okay, they all go in fifths. C D E F G. Right, G A B C D, D E F G A, and we're going on to what time it is now? We're going on to 4 o'clock, right? We're going to 4 o'clock. We're going on to 4 o'clock. 4 o'clock we're going on to, yes. Okay, 4 o'clock is so you play A major. So you go to you want the fifth note. 1 2 3 4 5. Five note, the fifth note is E. Let's change the notes a little bit. So you have 3 o'clock. You have 3 o'clock. You have E. So your E major scale go B. Same note you're playing from. But you're playing it from E, and you're changing. You're sharpening the seventh. You're sharpening the seventh. Okay. So you play from E and sharpen the seventh. Remember that F sharp. Remember that G sharp. Remember that G sharp. Remember that A. Right. Remember that C sharp. Right. And you're sharpening. After C is what? D, right? So you're sharpening that D. That sharpening that D could be E flat. Right. That D could be E flat. Once you sharpen that D, now you can sharpen. You must use the sequence of sharpening, and each note have to be an alphabetical note. It cannot change. You can't change note. All you need to do is sharpen or flatten the notes. Okay, like you can have an E and an E in one thing. You have to say D sharp. You can't say E. You can't say E flat. You have to say D sharp. And flatten your D and sharpen your D, okay? D sharp. Where are we playing from? We're playing from E. Sharpen your D, D sharp could be E flat. Yeah, let's say D sharp. Okay, guys, you can't say E sharp. You can't say E flat. You have to say D sharp. You have to be politically correct. Okay, D sharp. So next one, find the fifth note. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. B major is the next one. B major going at where? Where we at? 5 o'clock. Okay. It's in the evening. You finish work. Now you're coming home to relax. 5 o'clock in the evening. So you go. You're looking for 5 sharps. Okay. C have no sharps, no flats. G have 1 sharp. G have 1 sharp. D have 2 sharps. A have 3 sharps. E have 4 sharps. Now you're going down to B, which will have 5 sharps. You're playing the same C major scale, we're starting from B. Same E major scale, we started from B. Right? So start from B. Right? Now you see that? You see that? You see that C sharp there? You see the E flat there? You see the E? F sharp, you see the F sharp, you see the G sharp. See the F sharp and the G sharp. Right? After G is what? A. Ah, you have a sharp not A, right? So you sharp not A, you'll get B flat. Right? Sharp not A. You get B flat and you go to B. I know you should have the sequence by now, okay guys? Let's change voices. Right? So let's change voices. So we're going down to we in B, right? We at 5 o'clock, we find 5 sharps. Now we're going for 6 sharps now. 6 sharp is the ultimate. 6 is the ultimate sharps, okay? 6 sharps, okay? Next time that thing you go get flats, okay? 6, let's go for the 6 sharps. Okay, so take the B. 1, 2, 3. One, two, three, four, five. So F sharp is your F sharp is what? 6 o'clock. 6 o'clock in the evening. You come from work, you're relaxing, you know, you want to pick off. Well, I go pick up my pal and start practice. Eat some food, you're ready. 6 o'clock in the evening. 6 o'clock in the evening, you're home, you're relaxing, you finish work. It's 6 o'clock. You're looking for 6 sharps, okay? At 6 o'clock, you're looking for 6 sharps, okay? We're going to be F sharp. Go start from F sharp. Now, there's a way of, easy way of getting a sharp note. I saw a lady do it one time. A lady named Miss Rodriguez. She did that. And she finds sharp by sharpening every note. Saying your ABC from F and sharpening every note. The F sharp. So F sharp, G sharp, right? A sharp, B sharp, C sharp, D sharp, you know? E sharp. And back to F sharp, right? Sharp, know all them notes on them because you know where the F sharp, right? And in the, after F in your alphabet is what? G sharp, right? After G in your alphabet is what? A, right? A sharp. So that A, right? So A sharp is what? B flat. A sharp is B flat. After A in your alphabet is what? B sharp. B sharp is what? B sharp is C. B sharp. B sharp is C. Right? After B in the alphabet is what? C sharp. Right? after C in the alphabet is what? D sharp. D sharp is what? D sharp is E flat. Right? After D sharp. After D sharp is what? After D is what? After E is what? E F sharp. F double sharp. You gotta say double sharp. Let me figure it out, right? F sharp, G sharp, right? A sharp, F, G, G sharp, you sharpen your G, A sharp, you sharpen your A, which could be B flat, right? B sharp, you sharpen your B. That's just, that could be C. Right? B sharp, you sharpen your C. And C sharp, you C. Right? And you sharpen your. After C is what? D. You sharpen that D, you get E flat. Right? Sharpen that D, you get E flat. After D is what? E. You sharpen that E. Yeah, that way you're missing. You sharpen the E and you get the F. Power. Sharpen the E and I get the F to F sharp. Right? Let's change the voice. Let's go back. Let's go back to steel pan. Give me a steel pan. Right? So we reach at 6 o'clock. Right, 6 sharps. See much sharps in that one? Okay, so we only find one natural note in that one was C, right? So we find F sharp, we find G sharp, we find A sharp, which is B flat, we find B sharp, A B sharp, which is B, and we find C sharp, find D sharp, and find C, F. Only natural note is F in that. Only natural note is F. Right? Only natural note there is F. So, in order to find any sharp scale, anything saying sharp, it could be C sharp, it could be F sharp, G sharp, say alphabet and sharpen all those notes. Say alphabet from G, say G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A sharp. So say G sharp, G sharp, G sharp, A sharp, B sharp, C sharp, D sharp, E sharp, F sharp, back to G sharp. Okay? And sharpen all them notes and But you have to know something called enharmonics. Enharmonics is in one of the class I taught, have tell you about the different different notes with same notes and different song. They make a different song, but they got the same name. They make the same song, but they got different names, right? Like A sharp is B flat, right? B sharp is C, right? D sharp is E flat, okay? And so forth and so fifths, right? So you have to learn enharmonics. We talk about enharmonics in one of the class. Go back to my tapes, you will see something called enharmonics. They're going to teach you about those things, okay, guys? So we find the fifth, we find the sixth note at 6 o'clock. Now, what they do at 6 o'clock here is that they go right back at the top of the clock at 12 o'clock and start back. They go right back to the top of the clock at 12 o'clock here. They go right back at 12 o'clock here and start going this way. That's where you get fourths. Go back this way in fourths. We went this way in fifths and we came up to six. We get six sharps. We're going this way in fourths and we're going to get six flats. We go this way in fourths and we go find the six flats. Or each chord have one flat, and next chord have two flat, just like how we did with the sharps. One chord had two sharps, one chord 1 o'clock we had one sharp, 2 o'clock we had two sharps, 3 o'clock we had three sharps, 4 o'clock we had four sharps, 5 o'clock we had five sharps, and at 6 o'clock we had six sharps. But this time we wouldn't be doing like 1 o'clock. It could be 9 o'clock. You go find it could be 10 o'clock. So 10 o'clock you will get one flat. 11 o'clock you will get one flat. 10 o'clock you will get two flats. 9 o'clock you will get three flats. You know, 8 o'clock you will get four flats. 7 o'clock you'll get five flats, right? And then at 6 o'clock you will get the six flats on the other side of the scale. So let's go on the other side, okay, guys? Let's go on the other side and cipher this thing faster. Let's go take time, but this is a good teaching, okay, guys? This is a good teaching, so you could we have a lot to do with this circle of fifth. Most of my teachings will be on this circle of fifth. And we're going to play with it, and I will show you how to, you know, how musicians do it. You're going to learn while I'm learning, okay, guys? So.